here we are up in the sugar bush, checking out our remote vacuum monitoring system. We just put it in this year. It came from Smart Trek Technologies up in Canada. There's not too many sugar bushes that have it at the moment, but I think within a few years, many, many large sugaring operations will be putting these in because they're so useful. We have 29 of these nodes, what they're called, deployed at strategic places throughout our sugar bush. We can connect two main lines into the same box here, and it gives us pretty much real-time data on what the vacuum levels are at those main lines at that time. And therefore, we know where everything is working well, where our vacuum is high, and where the problems are, so that we can look at the data on our smartphone, check it out, and see what the vacuum level is for these lines. Anywhere we are, we can see it. I don't even need to be in the sugar bush. It can go through Wi-Fi to my smartphone. It's very useful for monitoring your performance, knowing where to go fix your problems, and knowing when problems arise. There's been many times this year already where we had a major catastrophe of a line pulling apart. We could see immediately the vacuum dropping and know exactly where that was and immediately go fix it, therefore keeping our vacuum high and allowing us to get more sap out of the trees. This is the tablet that shows a map of where all these nodes are. We kept one out just to be able to show you, but all the ones that we saw up in the woods, this is where they are on the map here. All the blue dots here. Here's where we are back at the sugar house. Okay, and you can see the directional arrows going out from our gateway unit here at the sugar house to all of the different nodes. And every time that it updates, every time it pings out there, it's getting new data. It's almost like real-time data on the vacuum levels and the temperatures. So you can go to the nodes pane, and we've labeled them all. We know what they are. So you can see here C2C and B7C. One's 19.2, one's 21.9. Nearly 3 inches of difference in vacuum there. So we know we have a leak, or maybe many leaks on C2C, and that's where we need to concentrate our efforts.